Good day to you all. Today's video session, we are going to see the remaining part of our chapter 8, Human Health and Disease. So in this chapter, we are going to see the theory part, that is drugs and alcohol abuse. Here, no more technical things is there, only the theory will be present around 2 pages. So you can get the direct questions from these theory part. Nicely, you can score the mark in this theory. Okay, so read the things once or twice. The use and abuse of drugs and alcohol by teens is very common nowadays, and it can lead to serious consequences. So in the age group of 15 to 24, 50% of the death from accident or maybe from suicide which involves alcohol or drug abuse only. So that the statistical reports nowadays saying that there is an increase in the consumption of alcohol only in among adults. Okay, so these alcohol consumption also lead to serious physiological as well as the sexual aggressions such as rape cases in our country. So government should have to enhance sincere laws and education and guidance are needed to, in order to safeguard the youngster against these dangerous patterns. Okay, so one should follow the healthy lifestyle, hence the physical well-being will be there. Okay, so these drugs are classified into opioids, cannabinoids, co-alkaloids based upon their occurrence and the functions. So most of the drugs are obtained from flowering plants as well as some from the microorganisms like fungi. Okay, so first we will see the opioid. Opioids are obtained from morphine. Morphine is also a drug. Okay, so these are obtained from the plant Papaver somniferum. Papaver somniferum is a plant. What we are saying, it is poppy seeds. Okay, so in Tamil we will say kasa kasa. So from that Papaver somniferum, that is, this is the latex of the plant. From this region only our drug morphine will get. So by means of acetylation process, so this morphine will converted into the opioids. That is, the two acetone group will get added and our water molecules will get eliminated. So see here the structure of this heroin. We can say opioids, another name is heroin. Okay, so this structure we are saying it is chemically diacetyl morphine. So opioids are the drug which are obtained by the acetylation of morphine. So these morphines are obtained from the plant Papaver somniferum, which is nothing but our poppy seeds plant. Okay, that is the latex of our poppy seeds. So this is the latex of our poppy seed plant. So from this only these drugs are arising. Okay, so these drugs, coming to the color, they are colorless, white and bitter taste and crystalline compound. Okay, so these opioids interact mainly with the opioid receptors on our nerve cells in the body and also the brain. Okay, so it is a depressant and slows the body function. Okay, so it is acting as a depressant. Okay, so these opioids mainly present in central nervous system as well as our gastrointestinal tract. So these drugs generally can be taken by means of injection or by means of snorting. Snorting means through nose they will take these drugs. Okay, so heroin also we can say it is a smack. So this heroin, morphine, so everything we are saying commonly as opioids. Next one is cannabinoids. So they are naturally occurring compounds found in the plant Cannabis sativa. So all parts of this plant, so nearly we are having 480 different components in this plant. Among that 480 different components, 66 components present in the plants are used for the drug production. Okay, so the flower top, the leaves, the raisins and all the parts of these plants are combined in a various combination and they are producing these different products, that is marijuana, hashes, charas and ganja. So these are all the different products which are obtained from a single plant, Cannabis sativa. Okay, so even from the inflorescence to the leaf, everything is used for the production of this ganjas, cashews, charas, marijuana. So these drugs, they also exert their effect by interacting with the specific cannabinoid receptors present on the surface of the cells in our central nervous system. Okay, so mainly these drugs are taken by inhalation as well as the oral ingestion. They are known for their cardiovascular system of the body, so which will obviously affect our heart rate. So this next one is cocaine. Cocaine, we can also say it is cocoa alkaloid or coke or cocaine. So these are obtained from the plant Erythroxylum coca. This is the plant where from there we are getting this cocaine. Okay, so they are said to be the recreational drug. In common, we are saying this cocaine as a recreational drug. Okay, recreation meaning altered state of consciousness, only for pleasure. Okay, only for their joyness they will take this drug. So if they took this drug, means they will feel like they are flying in the air. Okay, so this drug can be inhaled or snorted normally. So it will interfere with the transport of our neurotransmitter. Main neurotransmitter is said to be the dopamine. Okay, so what is the role of dopamine? Means it is a very important component in case of pharmaceutical chemistry as well as pharmaceutical biotechnology. So it is an important chemical messenger, okay, which involves in motivation, memory, and even regulating our body movements. Okay, so this is the very important neurotransmitter present in our body. So this cocaine will interfere with this neurotransmitter. Okay, so it produces the sense of euphoria in the sense of feeling of well-being, okay, and increased energy, even though the person is suffering from some depression or he or she may ill in their health. So if they are taking these drugs, they will feel like they are very safety, like increased in their energy. Okay, so for that purpose they are taking these drugs. So this excess dosage of these drugs will lead to hallucination. Hallucination means nothing but a change in emotion, change in thought, change in consciousness. Okay, so these drugs are mostly abused by sports persons. I have already told it can be taken by means of inhalation and snored means through nose. Sedatives are normally used as a medicine for treating the mental illness, depression and insomnia. So these drugs reduces the excitement by depressing our central nervous system actively, and also it lowers the physiological functions. Okay, so those drugs are benzodiazepines, barbiturates, amphetamines. These are the common drugs which are useful for the patients who undergone surgery, and it is also used to treat insomnia, as I told earlier. So these drugs are taken only for pleasure without the prescription by the doctors. Okay, so next one is smoking and tobacco. Tobacco, we know it has been used by the humans for more than 400 years. So it is smoked, chewed or snuffed. The nicotine, which is the chemical compound present in our tobacco, will stimulate our adrenal gland. So adrenal gland, which will releases the main component adrenaline and noradrenaline into the blood. Okay, these components plays an important role in the regulation of the body by means of the brain signals. So this will increase the blood pressure and also the heart rate. So it will also cause some oral cancers. Smoking, which increases the carbon monoxide content in our blood, and it will reduces the oxygen content in the body. So with increased level of lung cancer, urinary disorder, blood pressure and also increased heart rate was found in the people who are using this cigarettes. Okay, so it is injurious to health. It is much prevalent in the society for both young as well as the old peoples. Next is adolescence and alcohol abuse. So that the age 12 to 18 years are said to be the adolescent age. So this age acts as a bridge for the childhood and adulthood. So at this age, they will be more active and they wanted to do more adventurous things and wanted to do more experimental things. So which will motivate them to undergo the drug and alcohol abuse. So main reason for these drug and alcohol abuse is stress. Okay, so the stress in the family, or there may be a failure in the exams, something will lead them to go on the wrong way. It is the phase, that is the adolescent phase, is the phase in which the mental and psychological development will takes place. Okay, so I have told the causes for the drug abuse is the excitement is the main reason, and the illegal friends also lead this drug abuse. Next is addiction and dependence. So these drugs are commonly, normally if you are saying these cocaine, barbiturates, all these drugs are mainly used for treating the illness, patient with illness. Okay, so if these drugs are illegally used, means then that is said to be the drug abuse or addiction. So repeated usage of these drugs will increase the tolerance level of our receptors in our body, either in the central nervous system or in our gastrointestinal tract. So the receptors will get overstimulated. So obviously our body needs, it will lead to the high dose only. So for example, if a person who is addicted to coffee, they may prefer only strong coffee. Okay, in such a way their body was tuned, that is their body receptors was tuned. If they didn't took coffee even for one day, they can't live. Such a symptoms are said to be the withdrawal symptoms. If the regular dose of the alcohol or a drug is abruptly disturbed by their parents or by their guidance, means for by their guide, means obviously the patient will get these symptoms, that is the withdrawal. Coming to the effects of drugs and alcohol abuse, the drug users and toddlers, they always show reckless behavior, vandalism and violence. Here reckless behavior in the sense careless or irresponsible behavior, and vandalism indicates the damage to the public or private property. And always they look violent. So some major causes, that is the behavior and psychological change will occur. That is, they will show less interest in the studies, sports. Always they will look depressed stage, and fatigue and aggressive behaviors will be there. And social problems, they may turn to criminals like stealing and even murder. Due to their behavioral changes, economic problems may arise in their family. Okay. So AIDS and hepatitis. So this is for those who are taking the drug intravenously. Sometimes infected needles causes these diseases like AIDS and hepatitis. Okay. So misuse of drug by the sports person. Some drugs and hormones are taken by the sports person to enhance their performance, because they have to stimulate their muscle strength. Okay, so these anabolic steroids plays an important role, which is said to be the synthetic testosterone. We know that testosterone is a male hormone, so in females they cause masculinization, that is the features like males. Okay, use of these drugs during pregnancy affect the fetus, and chronic use of these drugs and alcohols damage our nervous system and also the liver, that is said to be the cirrhosis. Affect in the liver is said to be the cirrhosis. Okay, next one is prevention and control. So we know that prevention is better than cure. In this regard, we the teachers and the parents have a special responsibility to create awareness among yourselves. Okay, so avoid pressure. So every child has its own talent. A parent should not force them to fulfill their wishes. So education and counseling, each and every coin is having two sides. So likewise, as failure and success are a part of our life, we should not take failure as a serious issue. And we have to involve us in sports, music, yoga, reading. Likewise, we have to divert our mind. So searching help from parents and peers, that is very important, I think. So we have to share the problem with our friends. If we cannot share with our friends, we have to share with our family members. No one will give you the best solution except our parents, is it right? So try to share all with them. It will reduce your stress level. And also we can seek the profession as well as the medicinal help. That is, de-addiction program and rehabilitation programs can help the individual suffering from alcohol abusers. So they treat them very kindly. The next one is, we can say, as I can say, from this chapter, we have learned that microorganisms are a part of our life. So we have to keep ourselves and our environment very clean, because Cleanliness is next to godliness. So stagnation of water should be avoided, as well as personal hygiene is much more important nowadays. As in the case of COVID-19, personal hygiene is very, very important. So take vitamin C and rich foods and rich protein foods in your diets. So do moderate some exercises in your upstairs, and you can practice some simple yogas. You can get vitamin D in the morning, as well as study well, stay home and stay safe. So see you in the next class.